Welcome to With Intention. I'm your host, Desiree, and I am so glad you've landed here. But before we get started, this is a very different kind of first episode. Maybe you're the type of person that when you find a new podcast, you want to scroll all the way down to the first episode and listen from the beginning. Well, I'm recording this episode 105 episodes in. And I'm doing that because if you are going to listen through, I just want you to know this podcast has been through quite the journey and maybe even an identity crisis or two. Kind of kidding, kind of not, because what I'm trying to say is that I'm really glad you're here. I'm really glad you've scrolled all the way to the first episode, but please know that where we started is a much different place than where we are now. With Intention started as a podcast with a co-host. My husband and I started this podcast to share our story about how minimalism changed our lives. And at the time, the same podcast you're listening to now was called The Minimalist Family Podcast. You'll hear that if you listen through the first few episodes. Along the way, it briefly changed to a new name just for like a few episodes because we decided my husband didn't have the time to dedicate to weekly conversations, and I didn't feel like The Minimalist Family Podcast fit me if I was talking on my own, and so I just changed it on a whim and I didn't like that change. I actually ended up pausing the podcast for a while because the initial idea I had wasn't working, so I really didn't know where to go with it from there. But soon I was ready to get started again, and a name came that took me through nearly 100 episodes and a whole lot of growth, and that name was Minimalish. From the beginning, I wanted to share my journey with minimalism, and Minimalish was a way for me to do that, but I felt really boxed in by the idea of minimalism. I'm not a great minimalist, and I didn't want people to come to me and think that I was going to be their perfect example of a card-carrying minimalist. I still like stuff. I don't think consuming and shopping is all bad all the time. I like clothes, and I have one too many pairs of black leggings, even though they're all the same dang color. Minimalism for me has just become a boundary line. It helps me value other things more than, well, things, and it's also become a vehicle through which I redefine my priorities. And mostly, it's been my gateway to living with intention. Minimalish became a podcast that wasn't just about minimalism anyways. And these days, I'll still bring you episodes on the typical things, like decluttering, budgeting, and debt-free journeys, contentment, all of the things that you might categorize under the umbrella of minimalism. But I really don't think these things are just for the person who wants to have less stuff in their life. They're definitely not just for the person who wants to play the game of minimalism that I have opted out of. I don't think these things are just for the person who wants to see how little they can live with. I think these topics are for everyone. And for the record, minimalism can be for everyone too, but I think the word can scare people away. You get to decide how much of minimalism applies to you and your family and what it looks like for you. But I just try not to use the word as much anymore. It feels limiting and rule book-ish to me, and I figure it might feel that way to others as well. So as minimalism started to feel like it was boxing me in, even the word minimalish felt like a box to me. And so now you've arrived at the With Intention podcast. This podcast has grown and changed a lot, along with me, as we all do. But I've left all of the old episodes here because I want you to be able to go along the journey with me if you want to. You can start at episode one, or you can come back to where we are now and follow along with the With Intention podcast. But I know there are things here to be learned from the early episodes and the new ones. And there are guest episodes that I would never even think of deleting just because I changed the name of the podcast. With Intention is a podcast about finding joy and purpose in the everyday ordinary and living with intention in every area of our lives, our work, our motherhood, our relationships, our home life, the way we care for ourselves, and more. And I'm your host, Desiree, and I'm not an expert at those things. I'm not an expert at living intentionally. In fact, I often write and talk about the things that I need just as much as I feel that I want to share them, and maybe you need them too. I'm a very ordinary person living a pretty ordinary life that I seem to think is pretty extraordinary. I work full-time as a high school English teacher. I'm a mom to a 3-year-old girl. I'm a wife to my husband, Nick, who you'll hear every once in a while on the show and a lot at the beginning episodes if you do start at the beginning. My faith is at the center of my life, and it does come out in a lot of what I talk about here. But please know that I'm not here to tell you what to believe. I'm here to share my heart and I hope that if you find what we talk about here valuable, you can find a way to apply similar principles to your life in a way that makes sense to you, your beliefs, your values, and your family. No matter what you believe or what your life looks like or what your family looks like, you are so welcome here. I'm never coming from an expert standpoint, and I'm always here as a friend, talking through what I'm learning with hopes it'll resonate with you in some way. And I'll also bring on guests, friends, experts, other women, to talk us through topics that they have experience and passion in and to share their stories. I'm so happy you're here. And if you enjoy With Intention, the best thing that you can do to support the show is to share with a friend and subscribe so you don't miss an episode. I hope to continue to talk with you on one of the many episodes available here on With Intention. So I will talk to you on the next episode that you hit play on. Thanks for being here, friend.